Thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the great film Bridget Jones' Baby. I love this movie. I laughed. I cried more than once, which is kind of rare for me. But we were blessed not only to come to London, we have a great opportunity to see where Bridget Jones has lived, Borough Market, right outside the Globe Tavern. And we sat down with the cast of this film, including Colin Firth, Patrick Dempsey, and Bridget herself, Renee Zellweger.
So you have no idea which of us is the father?
Surely one of those dates is more likely.
They're both equally likely.
So do bring along the father if you can work out which one he is.
I love this character. I love her world and her friends and her family and being reunited with her and seeing what she's been up to all this time. It was a lot of fun. It was an interesting new challenge professionally to try to kind of figure out how a person's evolution manifests. And more importantly, how she hasn't changed, probably.
The director said she was actually more nervous this time around. Were you?
Probably. Yeah, probably. So many years.
Yeah.
Is it gonna work? Does the film matter? Is it necessary? Yeah, probably nervous. Yeah, we had a great time.
Bridget, who do you want to be the father?
I don't know.
There are two really good options here. You guys are both really good options. It's not like Daniel Cleaver, who is a cad, versus a good option. Two good options. How good are you at making decisions? When you have two good options, are you the kind of people that make pro-con lists? Do you rely on friends or do you go with your gut?
I just want both. I'll just go for both.
Yeah, yeah. Don't compromise.
Yeah, I'm
just say yes.
So much less complicated when you don't have to choose.
And you don't have to choose.
Yeah, I didn't have to choose. They just kept showing up at work. Yeah. It was really nice.
I feel like you have an unfair advantage. In American, American audiences know you as McDreamy.
Right.
I feel like they need a nickname. What would Colin's nickname be?
Oh, wow. I'll have to work on that one.
Mm-hmm.
Save it for the next interview.
It's a good one to think about. Yeah.
Some people just don't get nicknames.
No, it's pretty true.
I wanted one as a schoolboy. I never really got one.
Never got one as a schoolboy?
No, really, no.
Interesting.
I think it's a sign of affection and individuality. I don't know, something. But no, some people just don't get nicknames.
It's just hard to pin anything on you, really.
Yeah.
No, Mr. Darcy feels kind of like a nickname now.
Mr. Darcy.
Yeah, I mean, I hear it so often.
I'm sure it's probably followed you for a while.
I don't know.
Yeah. How are you?
Very well, thanks. How are you?
I'm fine.
Glass of wine?
I have a whiskey.
Big glass.
Double.
I think the fact that he's turned up unsolicited again, I mean, she still has feelings for him, and that's part of the problem, but the fact is that he's representing something that just won't really go away, I guess. So she'd manage without it, any or either or all of us.
And how did you two meet?
Oh. Yeah. Well, it was a great opportunity. I was excited about it and nervous at the same time, because you're coming into something that's clearly established, and will you make an impact and add value to it? And, all of that. It was fun, and they were so welcoming at the very beginning, and I enjoyed it. It was a rediscovery in many ways of the process and taking the time, and I really enjoyed watching them work.
Good God, Bridget, you're immense.
This is a two-man job.
You never call a woman immense, pregnant or not. You called her immense. And then you proceeded to...
You called her a what?
Immense.
No, immense.
Immense. Oh, immense. Yeah.
I wondered if for a moment if there was a... It was something
like... It was your accent. Yeah, like a mispronunciation of...
No, you're right. It was, I mean, obviously, it was written for me, and I might have protested had it not come from the heart in a certain moment. I will say it wasn't Renee. It was a big thing she was wearing strapped to her,
It was
This is like a Tom Cruise off the side of the plane stunt. No one pulled a muscle during that whole scene or running around holding her up. You were tilted and the legs were up. That looked dangerous to me.
It was precarious, yeah. It was.
It was a blast.
No pulled muscle.
It
was.
It was a lot of fun.
It was a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah. There were people standing by. I mean, we almost couldn't move.
Trips to the chiropractor.
Well, stunt guys.
Didn't you have an incident where you did fall?
Yeah, we had. But the very last day of the
fall
last time,
and
having walked,
Renee?
Spent weeks walking across London in that.
Yes, there's two, yeah.
No, there was the last final slippery day where I thought I'd...
It was raining.
And actually, it wasn't particularly difficult because you know, there was only a couple of feet we had to walk, and so I thought, I'm going to act like I've been carrying it. As soon as I decided to act,
we fell down.
So the key is do less. Do less.
I think we cheer for her, and she kind of makes it okay for the rest of us to be human.
Who do we have here?
I'm Bridget, and this is Jack, and this is Mark. Lovely. You're our second same-sex couple today.
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for Bridget Jones' Baby. You know what? It was worth the 12-year wait. I loved it. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. And of course, we'll see you at the movies.